43-year-old John Bosco Kibalama, an employee of the British American Tobacco, went missing on the 3rd June 2019. It is on this day that his wife Monica Nabukera, a mother of twins, last saw him. Nabukera says her husband told her on the fateful day that he was going to Makerere University.
Flying squad, they came, we gave them our reports, they took our statement.
By then, Kibalama had started showing interest in politics, which idea was opposed by the mother and the wife Nabukera.
So they could take photos in the phones. When he comes back, he's like, today we were there, you know, I went to meet Bobby, our MP. By then he was the MP. I was with the MP there, and we took photos. So I could see t-shirts, they were putting on red. The mom called me that, please help me talk to my son. I've tried, because I'm getting reports from different people in the village. He has joined politics, he's planning to stand, but me, I don't like politics. So when he came back that day, we talked, and I was like, even me, I don't support politics. I was like, if you people don't like politics, me, I want.
Nabukera says Kibalama had received threats before he was abducted, allegedly by security operatives.
Threat messages that they were sending him, he should surrender politics if he still wants his life. If not, he could join NRM and he leaves the party that he was planning to stand in.
It's close to 5 years since Kibalama disappeared. Yesterday, the Uganda Human Rights Commission released a report indicating that 18 supporters of the National Unity Platform, including Kibalama, were still missing, and the commission had opted to close their files.
Mr. Rubongoya did not avail us national identity card numbers for about 3/4 of the alleged victims.
One time I was on TV, the Prime Minister, Mrs. Nabanja, was like, we have Mr. Kibalama John Bosco. And he was like, we accused him of burning the police stations that were burned last year.
But we are fortunate that Kibalama was traced. He was arrested recently in October in a place called Kakiri. And he's one of those that is claimed to have killed police officers in Chiboga, Wakiso, and other places.
At the time Nabanja made this statement, Kibalama had gone missing in 2019. This raises questions how Kibalama took part in the alleged killings of police officers when he was reported missing way back in 2019. The disappearance of Kibalama reportedly caused the death of his mother. Kibalama was her only son.
So when he got to know the news, there the condition worsened, and that's how he passed on.
Nabukera told NTV that her children, who were about 2 years old then, have since gone through difficult times.
Because they were used of waiting for him bringing something when he's coming back home, so they could sit and tell you, we are waiting for our dad.
Following the report of the Uganda Human Rights Commission, the families of the missing supporters of the National Unity Platform have been advised to sue government to force government to produce them dead or alive.
Well, that does not actually remove state liability in as far as establishing the identity and the whereabouts of those people. As a legal and human rights principle, the state is responsible for the protection of all people's property and their lives. And as such, we invite the families, as well as NUP, to go to court and file what we call habeas corpus applications.
Dr. Ssewanyana says court can as well force government to compensate families of the missing Ugandans, because it's a duty of the state to ensure the safety of all its citizens.
Such redress could include, among others, compensation for loss of loved ones, as it may happen when there is an abuse of a right, an abduction, or a disappearance.
Jingo Francis, NTV.